In the past few lessons on software architecture, I have done my best to pick the most easily understood and practically useful topics that I could think of. As you saw, in my opinion, the single most universally applicable and important topic can be summarized with the phrase, separation of concerns. With that being said, there is one more thing I wanted to discuss, which is a process that occurs before writing a single method or class. I recall from my first year as a programmer that I really wished I had some kind of process I could use to design a new program. If you're in the same boat, then I think you will enjoy this video. The first step in designing any new application is to perform what I like to call, in general, problem domain analysis, or PDA. There are different ways to do this, such as problem statements or user stories, but both of these approaches are fundamentally the same thing. To put this into simple terms, a problem domain is some area of expertise, field of study, or aspect of a business which you, as the programmer, must ultimately represent virtually in a program. For example, a calculator program must virtually represent mathematics. A bank program must represent accounts, money, stocks, credit ratings, and so forth. A social media program must represent users, friends, posts, likes, etc. To summarize this whole process, problem domain analysis means two things. What information must my program represent virtually as data? What does my program need to do in order to solve some kind of problem for its users? An easy form of PDA is to write a problem statement. This was the first approach I learned, and it is a quick and simple way to get started. Now, before I proceed, keep in mind that our goal here is not to verbally describe the entire application in fine detail. Start with basic features only. If you follow my lessons in software architecture, adding new features later on will be very easy. Anyways, the idea here is very simple. First, write a plain language description of either your application or a feature of your application. My program will create a Sudoku puzzle which the user can solve. It will store the progress of this puzzle and create a new puzzle after one is completed. Second, pay close attention to the nouns and verbs in your problem statement. The nouns will tell you about what the data structures, such as classes, variables, and constants, will look like. The verbs will tell you about different logical entities, such as methods, classes, and interfaces. From there, you can create a new project and build anything that seems sensible as a foundation for your application's architecture. Another approach which is very common among software professionals is to create what are called user stories. User stories are essentially problem statements, but you write them from the perspective of your users. It is important to apply separation of concerns with each story. Each story should concern one primary noun and one primary verb. To take the Sudoku app as an example once more, as a user, I want to be able to complete a Sudoku puzzle. As a user, I want to be able to store my progress. As a user, I want to start a new puzzle after I complete a puzzle. Afterwards, you will follow a similar process of considering the nouns and verbs. What to do after problem domain analysis depends on your general approach to software development and the project requirements. Some people argue that users will prefer a poorly built application with a good user interface than a beautifully functional and efficient application which looks awful. As much as I hate to admit it, I think there is a lot of truth to that when it comes to recreational or mainstream applications. A pretty user interface will make your application look professional and is more likely to attract the average person. However, this approach can backfire if your app does not function properly, crashes often, or you are simply not able to build your beautiful designs. However, if you are building an application for a very specialized or technical profession, it might actually be very important to be more concerned about the efficiency, data structures, logic, and architecture of such an application. In this case, you should still try to avoid having an ugly user interface, but having a simplistic yet easy to navigate user interface might be your top priority. It all comes down to keeping an open mind and trying different approaches, while at the same time paying close attention to the project requirements.